Hello students, welcome you all in today's accountancy class, that is partnership firm fundamentals, guarantee of profit. Today is our last topic of this chapter, that is guarantee of profit. Now I will explain you about this topic. First of all, what is guarantee of profit? That is minimum amount of profit must be given to a partner. What is guarantee of profit? Suppose if there are three partners, that is A, B and C. C has given guarantee of minimum profit of ₹10,000. Why this guarantee is given? Or we can say, first of all, suppose earlier there were two partners A and B. Now they want to admit C for some managerial work, we can say, for anything else. So what they do? They give as a guarantee that we will give you 10,000 minimum profit. You contribute or you give your contribution in our firm. So that's why this guarantee is given basically. Now what happens, suppose if C has given the guarantee of 10,000 profit, then what will happen? First of all, we will see how much profit are earned by the firm during the financial year. If profit are accordingly that C got 10,000, then it's okay. But if profit are less, which is divisible to C, suppose there is a profit in the firm, that is we can say 27,000, and the profit sharing ratio between the partners is equal, that is 1:2, 1:1. In this case, C got 9,000 as a share of profit, but it has been given a guarantee of 10,000. So from where 1,000 will be borne, or we can say how we got 10,000 as a guarantee of profit. In this case, we will see the clause of guarantee that is mentioned in the partnership. What clause is there? Suppose the clause is that if there is any deficiency in the profit of C, then it is borne by A. Then the full 1,000 is given by A to the C. If the clause is that if there is any deficiency in the profit of C, then it is borne by both A and B equally. Then what will they do? A also give 500 from his profit, B also give 500. In this way, C must got ₹10,000. But the clause applies, which is mentioned in the partnership deed, that how they have to give that profit to the C. So that is a minimum amount of profit must be given to a partner. What is guarantee? Minimum amount of profit that is given to a partner. First of all, it will be fixed and then it will be given to a partner in any case. If he is getting more than 10,000, then it's okay. Nothing will be taken back or extra will be given to him. But if he got less than 10,000, then it has to be given more to make 10,000. Guarantee can be given by all partners in a specified ratio or by any of the partners. Okay? Guarantee can be given by, as I explained to you, that guarantee can be given by all partners. It is given in the question, or we can say in the clause, that whether both the partners will contribute or the contribution is given fully by one partner. That is a different thing which they have discussed in their partnership deed. If divisible profit is greater than the guaranteed amount, in such case the clause of guarantee gets eliminated. If in that example C is getting 10,000 or more than 10,000, then no issue. Then what happens? In such case, the clause of guarantee get eliminated. The clause of guarantee means the guarantee which is given by the A and B to the C. that whether A will give the full contribution or B will give, or they will give in some ratio. If any deficit in profit arises, then it not be handled as specified earlier. If there is any deficit in profit, same example, if there is any deficit in the profit of C, then what will happen? It not be handled as specified earlier means the ratio in which they are getting profit earlier is not, now it will not be followed, because C got minimum 10,000, then they have to cover up that 10,000, whether what they have discussed according to that. So this is the guarantee of profit, that if any partner is given guarantee regarding the profits, then he must get it. But how he get it? If he is getting equals to that profit or more than, then no issue, then clause of guarantee gets eliminated. But if he is getting less than guaranteed profit, then other partners will contribute, and they contribute according to the clause of their guarantee, which they have discussed, that whether they have to give, whether one partner give or other partner, or they will give in some specified ratio. Now, I will give you an example regarding this. Listen carefully. A, B, C are partners in a firm. Their profit sharing ratio is 2:1. A, B, C. Three partners are there. Their ratio is 2:2:1. C is guaranteed minimum of ₹10,000. C is guaranteed minimum profit of ₹10,000. As share of profit means the guarantee given to C is that he must got ₹10,000 as a guarantee of profit. Any deficiency arising on that amount shall be met by B. If there is any deficiency in the profit of C, then it is met by B. The profit for the 2 years, 2 years profit are given, that is 31st March 2018 is 40,000, and 31st March 2019 is given rupees 60,000. Okay. Prepare profit and loss account for the 2 years. Now, there are both the clauses are included in that. First of all, C is given guaranteed profit of ₹10,000. And if there is any deficiency in the profit of C, then it will be borne by the B. Okay. 2 years profit we have been given, that is 31st March 2018 40,000, 31st March 2019 60,000. Profit sharing ratio of all these partners are 2:2:1. First of all, we will take this year, that is year ending 31st March 2018. In this year, profit is 40,000. So, how we will distribute profit among all the partners? Three partners are there. A got 40,000. His share is 2. Sum of all the shares, that is 5. So, in this case, he got 16,000. Okay. B, profit is 40,000. B's share is 2, 16,000. Now, see, C is getting 40,000. His share is 1. He is getting 8,000. Now, see in this case, C is guaranteed minimum profit of 10,000, but he is getting only 8,000. So, what we will do in that case? In the question, it is given that C's minimum guaranteed profit is 10,000. If there is any deficiency in the C's share, then it will be borne by the B. So there is a deficiency in C's share. To make it 10,000, 2,000 more is needed, which is given by totally by B. So if B gives 2,000, then how much is left his share of profit? That is 14,000. So how we show it in profit and loss as provisional loss? This is the debit side and this is the credit side. Now, how will you get profit? First of all, we transfer the profit on the credit side by net profit. It is 40,000. Division of profit, because nothing is there in the question regarding interest on capital, salary, whatever mentioned in the profit and loss account. So, 2 profit transfer to capital account. Capital accounts of all the partners, that is A, B, C. Okay. Now, in this case, A is getting 16,000. B is getting 14,000 and C is getting 10,000. So 40,000 is divided among partners like that. This is, we can say, our case 1, where there is deficiency regarding C's share, which is borne by the B. Okay. Now we will take another case. That is, on 31st March 2019, profit is 60,000. Now see how we will divide this 60,000. Profit sharing ratio is 2:2:1. Okay, now divide 60,000 in that way. A got 60,000 into 2/5, 24,000. B also got 24,000. Now C got 12,000. Minimum guarantee given to C is 10,000, but he is getting 12,000. Then it's okay. No issue. We just write down the profit here, 60,000. Here we divide the profit among all the partners. A got 24,000 in case 2. Okay. B is also getting 24,000 and C got 12,000. So total will be 60,000. So there is no issue or no clause of guarantee is there. Guarantee of clause is eliminated when there is can say the minimum guaranteed profit is equal to that profit, or we can say more than that. So then we divide the profit as the specified ratio, or we can say the ratio which is given. We did not add or minus anything from any ratio. I will give you one more example. Listen carefully. Different cases are there in that example. Yes. A, B, C are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2:1. A, B, C profit sharing between them is 3:2:1. They earn a profit of rupees 30,000 during the year. Profit is equal to 30,000 during the year. Ended 31st March 2019. Distribute profit among A and B. Now different cases are, number one, we have to distribute this 30,000 among all these partners. C's share of profit is guaranteed to be 6,000. First case mein kya hai? C's share will be 6,000. Now, what we will do in that? First of all, we will discuss about case one. In this, A, B, C, three partners are there. Profit given is 30,000. We have to divide that 30,000. Okay. That is 3/6. We got 15,000. Then 30,000 2/6, that is 10,000. Then 30,000 minimum profit must be given to C is 6,000, but here he got only 5,000. So what they will do now, another thing is that minimum profit, this is just given in the question that 6,000 will be given to C. Okay, nothing is written here whether A will give the deficiency or whether B will cover the deficiency, who will do, nothing is given in the question. Now in this case, what we will do, we have to give 1,000 to C. C's profit must be 6,000. Now, how this 1,000 will come, or we can say who will give this 10,000? In this case, what you have to do, you just eliminate this share of C. Okay? Now, between A and B, ratio is 3:2. That is now specified ratio in which 1,000 is divided. 1,000 multiplied by 3/5, it becomes 600. Okay, it is given by A, and by B, 1,000 multiplied by 2/5, that is 400. So A and B will give to this 1,000 in this 3:2 ratio. Okay, sorry, it's 400. Now, who will give? A will give 600 from his share, and B will give 400 from his share. So, after deducting 600, what is left here? 14,400 and 9,600. In this way,
profit is divided among all these partners. If there is nothing will be given, or we can say nothing will be given about that guaranteed profit, then who will give the minimum guaranteed profit to the C if there is any deficiency? Second case. Same profit, 30,000 profit is there, but second case is that minimum profit payable to C amounting to rupees 6,000 is guaranteed by B. Okay, is guaranteed by A. Now, C got minimum profit of 6,000 and guarantee is given by A that if there is deficiency in the profit of 6,000, then who will give? Only A will give. Now, same. First of all, we have to divide profit among all the partners in their profit sharing ratio. Now, profit of C is only 5,000, but it must be given 6,000. So 1,000 is added to his profit. In this case, who has given the full guarantee? A. So 1,000 is taken from the share of A. So the share left of A is 14,000. B, no issue. Nothing will be taken from his B because B has not given any guarantee that he will give anything to C. Okay. This is our second case when full guarantee is given by A that if there is any deficiency in the profit of C, then it will be borne by the A. C. Next case, that is our third case. Guaranteed minimum profit of 6,000 payable to C is guaranteed by B. Now, C's minimum profit is the same, 6,000, but the guarantee is given by B. Then, when there is deficiency in the profit of C, then what will be there? It will be borne by the B. Okay? Now, 1,000 will be deducted from the B's share. B got 9,000. There is no issue of A. He will getting 15,000 as his share of profit, but 1,000 deducted from the B and added to the C. Means 1,000 is given by the B to the C as he has given the guarantee of minimum profit of C 6,000 to C. Next case is any deficiency after making payment of guarantee 6,000 will be borne by A and B in the ratio of 3 and 1. Same 6,000 is given, but the guarantee is given both by A and B. They both are ready to contribute, but they have fixed the ratio that 3:1, that A will give third part and B will give one part of his profit. In this case, profit will be calculated 1,000, which must be given to the C to make his profit as 6,000. It is given by both A and B. So 1,000 A will give 1,000 multiplied by B divided by 4. That is 3 parts of his share. So it will become 750. And B, he is ready to give 1/4. That is 250. So from A's share, 750 is deducted, and from B's share, 250 is deducted. In this way, A's share become 14,250, and B's share become 9,750. A got 6,000 as fixed. So in this way, you have seen different cases when A is giving full share or B is giving full share or if they are giving in ratio. So in this way, we will do these questions of guarantee of profit. With this topic, we are getting, we can say we have finished our chapter, that is very lengthy chapter, Partnership Firm Fundamentals. What we have done in this chapter, we have just first of all discussed about the partnership, partnership deed, profit and loss appropriation account, contents of profit and loss appropriation account, that is interest on capital, salary, commission, whatever is given to the partners, or interest on drawings which is charged from them. We have also discussed different methods of interest on drawings. After that, we have discussed about the partner's capital account. There are two types of partner's capital account, fixed capital account, fluctuating capital account. Then, after that, we have discussed about the past adjustment, and now this is our the last topic which I have discussed today, that is guarantee of minimum profit. Thank you. Have a nice day.